Welcome to The Prep Pursuit. I'm Devereaux, an etiquette and image consultant at The Poise Pursuit. I work with busy working professionals around the world, helping empower them with confidence and charisma to advance their companies and careers, using etiquette and style as tools for success. Welcome to today's video. We are very, very pleased to have a special guest here on the channel. Meet my friend Damon Levine. He is a multifaceted entrepreneur here in Dallas. You can learn all about everything that he does for clients at damonco.com. Damon, thank you for joining today.
Thank you, Deborah. I'm so honored to be here. I'm excited.
We're so excited to have you on the channel.
Thank you.
So today's topic is 10 pet peeves for entrepreneurs. These are the things that entrepreneurs just get so annoyed with, and it's going to be a fun video just to kind of make light of the challenges of being an entrepreneur. So I hope you enjoy it. So the first pet peeve of an entrepreneur for me is working with unprofessional people.
Oh my gosh.
If someone is unreliable, they're not accountable, they make a commitment and they just fall through, it's not professional, right?
Those are not the
people you want to collaborate with, you want to partner with for your business. Being an entrepreneur is a very serious matter. You are spending time and investing really all the resources that you have to get a return on that. You're helping people, you're providing them with a product or a service, but who really has time to waste?
I don't know
too many people that do. So that's my number one pet peeve, is working with unprofessional people.
You know, mine is a general lack of preparation. So I'm sure you've experienced this, just dealing with people, dealing with other business professionals, dealing with clients. A lot of times people walk into a situation and there's just a lack of preparation. Like having you go into a meeting and then the other person just did not even know how to discuss a topic with you.
Exactly.
Right. So I've had those types of situations, and I have to admit that's one of probably my top pet peeve that I hate. Just walking into a meeting and the person just doesn't even really know how to relate. So that's an issue. One of the things I really prefer is when we go into a meeting, I've done homework about you, you've done homework about me, and now we can have a great conversation. One where they'll probably have action items fall out of the meeting. There'll be a really good dialogue, a fantastic agenda, and then we'll really get some great entrepreneurial work done.
Yeah, that's the whole point of a meeting, is
getting
business done.
Right.
Number three on the list of top 10 pet peeves for entrepreneurs is putting in a lot of time, work, and effort and feeling like you get no result.
Yes.
Now, every entrepreneur feels this way, honestly, and it's just a part of the process. But yes, it is annoying. It's kind of like a pain in your side. And
absolutely,
you just have to keep pushing. You have to be consistent. So for all you entrepreneurs out there watching this, keep pushing, because all the time and the effort you put in will always reap a reward and a benefit at the end, but you have to be consistent. You can't just give up or throw in the towel. You have to remember why you started the business in the first place. Use that as motivation to push you through while you're going through a difficult time when it just feels like you're getting no results from the work you put in.
And Deborah, I think that's a fantastic point. I would have to say for me, number four, to piggyback off of what you're saying, is unrealistic expectations. So I even had to learn that part. You know, I had moments where I just thought I was going to do this fantastic work and it was just going to naturally happen. But there's something that I had to do. I had to set my expectations. I find myself doing that for myself and my clients, or just colleagues that I meet, really. Somebody has to be the person that level sets what we're going to do, level sets expectations for any project, whether that's for a group of people or yourself, and then proceed with getting the project done.
I love that. Really thinking through what realistically you can accomplish, especially in a specific timeline, so important for success.
All right.
Number five on the list of 10 pet peeves for entrepreneurs is inconsistency. Now, if you're an entrepreneur and you work with other entrepreneurs, this could relate to their quality of work. If, say, for example, you're hosting an event together or you're working on a project and you're sharing the workload, but if someone is really kind of falling off the wagon with the quality of their work and just really not bringing their best to work with you, that can be very, very frustrating.
Yes.
Now, on the client side, if you're working with a client and they say they want one thing, and then 2 weeks later they want something else, especially for creatives out there, like a graphic designer, and you're working with a client that keeps changing their mind, how annoying is that, right? Like, you just keep spending time running in circles, chasing after the different directions they want. So that is my number 5 pet peeve on the list of the top 10.
I would say for me, number 6 would be not having measurables. And this became really important for me as I matured through my entrepreneurial journey. So there has to be something built into your system for success where you're monitoring what your objectives are, looking at your results, and then seeing where you are in measuring them. You cannot skip that step. I'm sorry, entrepreneurs, you've got to learn how to do that. And when I meet an entrepreneur who hasn't figured out their system yet or measuring their success, then I'm wondering how we're going to be successful together. So that would have to be mine, definitely. Another one.
Measuring results is something that's so hard for some entrepreneurs, especially if they have service-based business, I think. If it's not selling a product and the goal is selling 1,000 units a month or a week, you know, it can be more difficult. But that's so important, because how can you know if you reach success if you don't define it?
Right. Absolutely. I love that.
Oh, we should save that for a tweetable. Okay, number 7 on the list. Damon, you just made a great point about results, and that reminds me of strategy. So again, when you are working with either a client or if you're working with another entrepreneur to work on a collaboration or a project together, having a strategy and a sense of direction is so important. Because if you don't define what it is you're working on, then how are you going to get anything done? Or if you are getting work done, it's just like action but no result. So you really want to have a strategy and a direction in place for the project, for the work, and use that to guide you throughout getting it done.
Right. You know, another one that I have as an entrepreneur working with other entrepreneurs is I've noticed that there is sometimes selfishness in the marketplace, and there's a failure to wear the shoes of the other person. So let me give you an example. Like, I'm a service provider, and then I meet a client, but we may be friends, and then they walk into the situation, and because they know me, they're automatically asking me for a discount or a way to give them services for free. And that's because they haven't been with me on a journey to understand what it took for me to even set up the business and the countless hours I put into setting up the infrastructure. But on the flip side, a lot of times when I walk into the situation, I make sure that I try to see what the other person has gone through. That's the only way I could relate to my clients. And even when we have a meeting, that's the only way I can relate to the person that I'm collaborating with, is if I've done the homework at front and then try to wear their shoes so that we can do some great and phenomenal work together.
Relatability is so important. It really is, to build that relationship. And that's what we do as entrepreneurs. We're building relationships, whether it's a product or a service.
Right.
But it's really all about connecting with other people.
Connection. Heart connections. That's what I like to call them.
I love that. Okay, number 9 is really about getting so deep into the details that you forget to look at the big picture.
Oh,
now,
wow.
For a lot of entrepreneurs that are type A, let's be honest, I know I'm not the only one out there. We're always busy going towards the next project, the next goal, the next action item. But really, after you achieve an amazing success, it's important to spend some time reflecting and really enjoying that moment.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, if you're really into the details, you can't sometimes see the big picture and how things fit together. So just having that perspective of balancing the details with also the big picture will really help set you up for success.
Absolutely. And for number 10, I would have to say that as entrepreneurs, and I hate to do it, but I have to do it, is always looking inside of myself, doing some self-introspection, and also doing self-improvement on a continual basis to make sure that I'm always successful. So I know when I fail to do it, and I can also see when others do. But that's something that we have to do as entrepreneurs. The world is constantly changing around us, so that means we have to educate ourselves, always monitor what our strengths or weaknesses are, and then improve our weaknesses, you know, develop our strengths, and do that on a constant cycle all throughout our entrepreneurial journey.
That's so important. And you know, I think it's really interesting, Damon, the people that get certifications and attend conferences compared to the people that don't, because if you
right.
don't have that level of self-improvement continually, it's not like you launch your business, okay, you're done.
Right.
Now you really have to stay ahead of the game and ahead of the curve, because you're providing something to your clients or your customers. So you want to make sure that you yourself as an entrepreneur are able to give them that highest quality and that highest level of service or product.
Absolutely.
Well, Damon, thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you so much, Devereaux. This was definitely a pleasure.
This
I'm so happy to be here.
Amazing. I'm so glad you were able to join us. And I hope you enjoyed this video. This was 10 pet peeves that entrepreneurs have. It's just a lighthearted, fun video, but you can actually get some really great ideas for ways you can improve yourself as an entrepreneur. Now, Damon is going to have all his links in the description below, so follow his website, check out his service offerings, and follow him on social media. He's got some great things and advice to share with you.
Thank you, Devereaux.
You're welcome. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new to the channel, I hope you subscribe. Stick around, because I share new videos every single week. Once you subscribe, you'll always get an update when I've got something new to share. Thank you for tuning in today, and I look forward to seeing you again in another video to help you thrive personally and professionally using etiquette and style as tools for lifelong success. Bye!
Bye-bye!